Today's video is going to be packed with useful tips and hidden areas of Adobe Illustrator. So the first tip relates to logo designing or even some of those people who work on illustrations, but it can be applied to pretty much any workflow in Illustrator. Simply come up to Window and add a new window. Now you're going to notice that I have the same document, but just version 1 and also version 2 as you can see here. Well, let's go ahead and arrange the windows as a tiled orientation and let's see what happens. So the awesome thing about this setup is that I can have one window zoomed really far into my design and the other can be a broad outlook of the overall design. And of course that means I can be working on finer details zoomed right in on the left, and then my logo on the right is also going to be changed as I work on the left, but I get a broader kind of picture of what's happening on the right hand side. I can also select the design on the right and press Command H on a Mac or Control H on a PC, and this should hide anchor points so I can see the design a lot clearer. So yeah, this first tip is an intuitive way to work on your design with two windows open at once. But let's move on to the next Illustrator gem in today's video. Now sometimes people ask me, how do I fill my artboard with a completely bold solid color? Now the trick is I often don't even have an artboard there at all. So in the view menu, we can hide the artboards like so, and now we're left with a giant workspace in Illustrator. Then we can come into the file and document settings and adjust the transparency option. Now yours won't be orange as default, and you can come into these squares and choose a color. There are various different options that allow you to select colors in different and interesting ways. And you even have a choice of sliders that include the HSB seen here. And that is of course, hue, saturation, and brightness. So when you've chosen the color, click the red X icon in the top left of the panel. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that you can actually drag colors into the little swatch UI below seen here. Now I don't want to check the background, and so I'd like to have the same color on both options, which is my cool blue. But once you have chosen your colors, come back into the View drop-down menu and then click Show Transparency Grid. Now you have a giant space filled with a bold color of your choice. Before we move on to the other useful tips in today's video, we have some quick words from a long-time sponsor of this channel, and that is Milanote. Now as a graphic designer, I do feel the need to have functionality and streamlined planning at my fingertips. And that's why I've partnered with Milanote for 2 years. It's visual planning for us designers. And as a logo designer, that's absolutely crucial. But it's a lot more than just that. As you can see on screen, I've invited a work partner onto this project board. And they can leave comments and even emoji reactions. I can also do that too. And this offers a teamwork functionality and also a client-to-designer relationship dynamic. With Milanote, you can create lists, mood boards, notes, typography choices, drag and drop imagery, and so much more. Now it has become a staple of my design process, and if you want to learn more about Milanote and also to sign up for free, click the link in the description box below and head over to the sponsor of today's video, Milanote. Okay, so tip number 3 is a setting that you probably have overlooked. Now I'm sure many of you know about the caps lock option on your keyboard, as that will actually change some tool icons into a crosshair, as seen here. And this helps with precision and also just a view of your design. But yeah, this isn't probably news to a lot of you guys, and you can use this on the brush tools and so forth, but there is a setting that you do want to take into consideration. If you press Command or Control K, and then you bring up the preference settings, you can then come into the general settings, and there is an option to select precise cursor icons. And this means you don't need to have your keyboard stuck on uppercase caps all of the time, and you can still use the precision crosshairs whenever you want to. Now I often like to use these when I'm working on detailed designs, because some tools, such as the pen tool, do obstruct your view from the design and just your workflow. So yeah, do keep in mind that little setting in the preference settings. So the next tip is actually a few small tips when working with blends. As all of us know that you can press W on your keyboard, and that would access the blend tool, and then you just click different shapes to generate a really smooth blend in Illustrator. Now one issue is that you don't have quick access to curve and, you know, bend your blend, so to speak, because it's in a fixed straight line. But even with a direct selection tool, you can't really do anything about it. However, if you press P for the pen tool, and then hold down the Alt Option key. You can now curve and manipulate your blend path like so. Also, you can hold down the Command key on a Mac or the Control key on a PC while you're using the Pen tool, and this will give access to the Direct Selection tool as seen here. And releasing that button on your keyboard will actually revert back to the Pen tool. Not only that, but when working with a blend and using the Pen tool, you can change the direction of the blend by clicking one end of the blend. But the issue is that you now have continued the path. But that's not a problem, because all you need to do is hold down the Command or the Control key and then click away onto the artboard. Let's take a look at that again one more time. And yes, simply just clicking away while holding down Command or Control will deselect the path. So I have two more tips that could very well blow your graphic design mind away today. And the first of those two tips relates to this star tool. And with this tool, I'm sure many of you guys know that if you click the up and down arrows while generating a star, you can add or decrease the amount of points on your star. Simple stuff, but while generating that star, you can also hold down the Command or Control key, and this will dictate the length of those points as seen here. So again with the star tool, while holding down the Command or Control key, we can go almost as smooth as a circle and then all of the way up towards a really long spiked kind of shape. And of course, everything else in between. That Command or Control key has been quite influential in today's video. But yeah, the final tip today is about color. And Illustrator has so many aspects that help you guys with color when working on designs. But in the swatches panel, there is a color themes window. Now this is something that I've recently been making quite a big use of, and that is in the explore option of this panel. Now we can give searches for a kind of a mood, a color, an emotion, a noun, whatever you want to search for. There are many pre-built color themes that you can perfectly match to your design. But let's go back to my search for ice cream, and you will notice there are three dots below every single theme seen here. By clicking that, we can see we can add a color set to our library, we can add them to our swatches, we can view them on the web, or even edit them right now. For my workflow, I often do add them to my swatches library, and then I can just, you know, use them on my design as I go. But yeah, there are some things you probably didn't know about Illustrator, and of course, if you do also want to improve your workflow when designing, check out Milanote, link down below. Also, click a video on screen to learn something else today. Until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.